I am Taimur Rashid, Head of Generative AI Innovation and Delivery at AWS. Join me as I talk to leaders and innovators across Amazon who are using AWS Generative AI to create hyper-personalized experiences for customers, streamline operations, improve productivity, and so much more. Learn more inside Gen AI at Amazon. Today, I'm joined by Asa, and welcome to the show.
Thanks for having me here.
Yeah, absolutely. So tell us a little bit about yourself and what you do here at Amazon.
Yeah, I lead the team that's responsible for our tools and experiences for our go-to-market organization. So if you think about solution architects, account managers, customer success managers, they all need tools so we can engage with our customers in the most proactive, contextual way. And we are really building the tools and the experiences for these teams.
Okay, that's great. And how are you using generative AI to address some of these needs of the sales teams?
So I'll give you one example. So you know, at AWS, we always think customers first and we work backwards from our customers. And so one of the big things that we want to do as we are getting our field teams ready to engage with customers is to provide them the most relevant, timely information about the customer so they can engage them based on their context, their business needs, and so on. So one of the first applications we built with Gen AI was around customer 360 data and research. So we collect information about the customer, such as their usage, their services, their workloads, from what we know. But we also marry that with publicly available third-party information. So what industry is the customer in? What is their priority? You know, any key product launches, any announcements, how their exec teams are structured. And so all of that information can be put together in a very easily consumable form that our account managers can access on demand, just when they're getting ready for the meeting. Or in other cases, we can even push that to them when we know a meeting is coming up. And so this really arms our field teams to have the latest information about the customer so they can engage them in the right way and give them access to the right products, services, solutions that they are looking for.
No, that's great. And in fact, it's great to see that you're using the working backwards process and starting, you know, with the customer in mind and then figuring out what to build from there. As you went through that process, were there several sorts of use cases or actual, you know, specific business problems that you were looking to solve, whether it was to drive more productivity for the sales teams or just reducing the time that sales teams went through the process of learning about an account?
I like to think of them as three main things that we've been looking at from a categories of use cases perspective. The first is customer research intelligence. And I'll go into all of these, but so customer research intelligence, being able to produce content that is hyper-personalized, and then information retrieval. So those are sort of the three broad cases. So I'll give you a couple examples here. So if you think about customer, you know, research and information pieces, the customer 360 is one example. Another one is if you think about our services, if we can take information about all the feature requests from the customers about our services, any support cases that come along and find, you know, are these friction areas for the customers to use our services. So we bring that together, collate it again in a form that's easy to consume, and we can feed that back to our service team so they can use it for their roadmap management. So, and you can think about all kinds of scenarios where you want to make information access easy. The second scenario or the category of use cases is around content generation. So now think about, you know, you're writing an email to a customer. What if you got all of the context for that customer put together so you have a draft and then you can build on that and send a really personalized email? All kinds of places where we are creating documents and creating content, we can sort of get a jump start on that by using the generative AI capabilities. So that's the second category. And then the third category is around information access. So, you know, our teams need to find out the most, you know, common business processes, you know, how do I create a private pricing agreement? Or, you know, what are the common customer references that I can use to share back with my customer? So, you know, gone are the days when you want to go to wikis and, you know, different documents and try to search for info. So we've brought all of that together and using Amazon Q, made it accessible in a conversational way. So our field teams have in the data at the tip of their fingertips.
Now, those are all really exciting areas. You know, 15 years ago, I used to be a sales rep myself, and I kind of wish I had some access to these tools as a sales rep. You know, maybe I would have actually met my quota. But, you know, that's great. What are some of the benefits you all are seeing so far? I know it's still early days with what you've implemented here, but any early signals of benefits that the teams are reaping from this investment?
Yeah, it's been, like you said, it's early, but we are excited. I think we look at the beginnings of productivity improvements, right? So the customer research that I mentioned saves our teams anywhere from 30 minutes to several hours, because that's the time they used to spend collecting this data. And now, if you think about it, we've generated over 100,000 of those so far. So you can think about the, you know, tens of thousands of hours saved from doing, you know, relatively monotonous work, and they can now use that time for more strategic thinking. And that's kind of the beginning, right? You can start helping with productivity. But then what's exciting is, you know, one of the favorite data points that I got when we did some customer research on this was at least a third of the people that were using this capability said they did not know we had this information about the customer. And they actually changed the way they engaged with the customer. They were able to do more. And so that's sort of the big benefit is, how do you access the nuggets out of all of this information so that our teams can be more effective with customers? We're also seeing increase in the size of opportunities, the types of things we can do. So there's the business outcome that you can think about at the end of it. And what's really worth noting here is that we can do this at scale, right? When we're collecting this detailed information about a customer, you know, previously we could do this for our, you know, larger accounts or more strategic customers. But now with this, you can do it at scale for every customer, every industry, every size. And so you can really give that hyper-personalized attention to every customer and really deliver what they need in their context, because that context also changes, right? Who you're engaging with, what business they're in. And so that's really the benefit here, which is we can do things that are much more customer focused and at scale.
Yeah, no, that makes a lot of sense. You know, I wanted to shift gears just a little bit and learn a little bit more about the technology, right? So all these great features that you're bringing to sales reps and field teams, can you talk a little bit about the underlying AWS technology, more specifically the generative AI services that are being used to power this experience?
Yeah, we've been users of Bedrock and Q from the very beginnings, even before they went GA. So we've been working closely with the teams, getting access to their latest features and testing them out. So a lot of the fundamental work that we do around summarization and content generation uses Bedrock. We use different models based on Anthropic. But again, depending on the type of function, the type of use case, we can use different models within that. And then for our conversational capability, we're using Amazon Q for Business. And that becomes a foundation to create the knowledge bases and start delivering the Q&A capability based on that. And then alongside that, we use a lot of the SageMaker capabilities, the ML models, because you can then tie ML and insights with the generative capabilities to really, you know, deliver a lot of what I was talking about.
Yeah, it's great to see all these building blocks coming together to, you know, create a very tailored solution for, you know, the sales teams. You know, obviously you and many others here at Amazon are trailblazing with how to use generative AI within their teams. Can you tell a little bit about a few lessons learned that, you know, as others think about doing something similar, they can kind of learn from those best practices?
Yeah. Well, it's been a fun journey, right? It's like we are at the forefront of things. We are learning as we go. But I think there's three key takeaways. If I look at our 12 to 18 months of work in this area, the first one is how data and ML come together. The second one is prioritizing based on business outcomes. And the third is how you can do, how you need to do more continuous testing. And I'll elaborate on all of them. So the data and insights piece. Obviously, a lot of this depends on data. So having good, clean, foundational data is important. As we brought this data together, we realized, you know, sometimes there's duplicate, sometimes there's missing data, sometimes there is, you know, data that's not being used as much. So how can you be more prescriptive about the data? So we spend a lot of time on clean data. The second lesson learned was prioritization, right? We are at the forefront of so much excitement that, you know, there's hundreds of use cases that you can solve. We literally have our spreadsheets of, you know, 100, 200, 300 use cases. They keep adding up. But it's really important to be laser focused and prioritize. It's easy to get distracted and start doing a bunch of things. But the areas that you focus on should be both business impacting as well as, you know, capable of being delivered by the technology that we have today. And lesson three is feedback, right? So much of this technology is new that earning trust with our teams, making sure we're building the right output, that content is really helpful, is important. So our teams spend a lot of time with one-on-one conversations with our early users, get that feedback in. We have at-scale feedback, so every single question and answer or feedback, you get the both up and down versus the actual qualitative feedback. And then we kind of use our LLMs to keep testing, right? Is the content generated what's equivalent to what the ground truth of good looks like? So getting that continuous feedback and training our teams to use it, because awareness, change management is equally important.
Yeah, that's really exciting. I really enjoyed this conversation, and thank you for sharing your experience as you built this amazing technology for the field teams.
Thank you. Thank you for having me here. We are very excited and more than happy to share our learnings and learn from all other organizations doing similar things.